Welcome back. In the last lecture, we have seen about how to convert the regular expressions. That means how can we construct the finite automata from the given regular expression. So in the last class, we have seen some basic examples on it. And in this lecture, we are going to consider some little complex examples, and we are going to see how we can construct the finite automata from the regular expression. So here you have a regular expression 0 star 1 plus 1 0. So as the complexity of the regular expression increases, directly construct a finite automata from the given regular expression is little difficult. So for this, we need to divide the regular expression into parts as possible. So here just consider this regular expression into two parts. This is like a plus b. That means one thing is clear, that we only need to concentrate on reaching the final state from initial state. So here a plus b, in the sense, whenever you have plus symbol here, you have a choice of reaching the final state. So you can reach the final state either this way or this way. So let us assume that here you have a plus b as a regular expression, and first construct the finite automata for that regular expression. So here I have taken this is the initial state, and here is my final state, and here I am assuming that this is a and this is b. So here plus means what? You can reach the final state either by going through a or by going through b. So I can have this path having 0 star 1, or I can have this path 1 0 to reach the final state. So after constructing the minimal finite automata, let's construct the next level by again assuming the individual part of the regular expression and expanding that like that. So here if you consider 0 star 1, so here initially you should have 0 star to reach the final state. Initially you should have 0 star, and after that you can have 1. So 0 star is nothing but closer. So closer usually it can be represented in the finite automata with the self loop. So here the same I can write like this. So q naught as it is. So here is q1. This is the final state. And here I am having 1. And before 1 I should have any number of zeros. So this can be placed here. This self loop can be placed here. So here the 0 star 1 can be represented like this. Okay. And here you are having 1 0. Here in this path you are having 1 0. 1 0 in the sense what? 1 0 in the sense here is a concatenation. That means you should have 1 and after that you should have 0. So this can be expressed by taking another state in between. So let us assume that this is QF. QF in the sense this is the final state. So here I am taking another state, that is Q1. So instead of directly writing 1 0, here I am taking 1 here, and from Q1 to QF I am taking 0 here. So this is simply the regular expression, this is simply the finite automata for the given regular expression. So here what we have done is initially we need to divide the regular expression to the extent possible, and after that I am considering that this is like a plus b. So I need to have two parallel paths to reach the final state. So here is one path and here is another path. So after that, to construct the finite automata to the next level, what I need to do is I need to observe each and every part of the regular expression. So if you observe here, here you can have a 0 star 1. So here you can have 0 star 1 in the sense, so 1 should be there, and before that you have zeros any number of times. That's what we have represented here. And in the bottom path here you have 1 0. So 1 0 in the sense you need to have 1, and after that you need to have 0. So for that we have introduced another state and we have written like this. So this is the required finite automata for this regular expression. So this is the way we have deal with the complex regular expressions to construct the finite automata. So let us consider another example. 1 0 plus 0 plus 1 1 0 star 1. So here also the same scenario. Okay, let us assume that this is a and this is our b. So again we are having just like this. Here also we are having two parallel paths to reach the final state. So here I am having q naught. This is the initial state, and here I am having some qf. This is the final state, and to reach the final state I can have 1 0 as a path, and I can also have this 0 plus 1 1 0 star 1 as another path. So after constructing the first level, next we need to consider each and every part of the regular expression and try to expand this by enhancing the diagram. So here the same case, here you have 1, 0, right? Here also you have 1, 0, which means that you need to have another state in the middle of these two, and you need to have one as a input initially, and after that you have 0. So the same thing I'm going to write here, Q0 I'm having initially, and here I can write Q1, and here I can have Qf, final state. So initially I need to reach with 1, I need to reach Q1 with 1, and after that I can reach Qf with 0. So this path is over, right? We have constructed up to the maximum extent. And consider the bottom path. Here you have 0 plus 1, 1, 0 star 1. So again, consider this as, you can consider this as two parts A, B, or three parts A, B, C, whatever you can consider in any manner. Since here I am having 0 star, that means here I am having closure, it doesn't require any specific path. It only requires self loop. That's why I am considering this part as A and this part as B. So again, I am dividing that by taking another state in middle. Let us say this is Q2. And here I can write 0 plus 1, 1. And here I can write 0 star 1. Here I can write 0 star 1. So there is no need to do further for this path, which is having an upward direction. And for this path, you need to further expand the finite automata. So here, as you observe, you are having plus symbol here. So that means what here you need to have a parallel paths. Since here you have a plus symbol, which means that you need to have a parallel paths here. You need to have a parallel paths. So here, let me write here. Here I am having Q0. Let me change the ink. So here I am having Q0. Here I am having Q1. This is the final state and this is the initial state. And here I can have Q1 and I have 1 and 0 paths. Sorry, 1 and 0, right? 1 and 0, okay. And here from Q0 to Q2, I should have two parallel paths. One is with 0 and another is with 1, 1. So I can reach, consider this is Q2. I can reach Q2 either with 0 or with 1, 1. And here I can write 0 star by taking self loop here. So I can have self loop with 0 and I can reach the final state with the input 1. So what is need to be expanded further means this one. So here 1, 1 in the sense concatenation. Concatenation in the sense you should have two paths in a serial manner. So first path is with input 1 and after that the second path is also with input 1. So this may be the final automata. So again you are having Q0. This is the initial state. And here you have Q1 and here you have the final state Qf. So you can reach this with input 1 and this with input 0. And again you have a state Q2 and you have 0 here. So instead of 1, 1, you need to take another state. Let us say this is Q3. So here you have 1. Here you have another 1. So you can reach Q0 to Q2 with the inputs 1, 1. And you can reach the final state with 1. And here you have self loop 0. So finally, this is the required finite automata for the given regular expression. So in this way, you can have the regular finite automatas. And let us consider another example. So here in this example, you can divide this regular expression into three parts. It looks like ABC. So for this, I need to have one initial state. And after that, here I can write my A. A is nothing but 0 plus 1 whole star. And here I can write my B. B is nothing but 0, 0 plus 1, 1. And here I can write my C. This is the final state, right? So here C is nothing but 0 plus 1 whole star. So remember that here is 0 plus 1 whole star and here is the same. So whenever you have a closure, no need to have specific path for it. So usually closures are taken with the help of self loops. So no need to have a path here, right? So here I can take the closure for at Q0 itself. So for Q0, I can have 0 plus 1 whole star in the sense I can put 0 or 0 plus 1 here. 0 plus 1 in the sense 0 comma 1. That means I can go either with 0 or with 1. So here there is no way you can take epsilon. And here you can have q1 here. And after that again divide this regular expression into two parts. This is like a plus b. So whenever you have a plus, you can reach the next state by using some parallel paths. So from q1 to q2, I can reach q2 with either 0, 0 or with 1, 1. Either 0, 0 or with 1, 1. And again, you need to reach q2 to final state qf. And observe here also you are having closure. So this closure can be indicated with the self loop. So you can have a self loop here with 0, 1. Here there is no input, you can take epsilon. So this is like epsilon NFA. Let us further reduce this. So here initially you should have a self loop of 0, 1. And after that you can reach the next state with either 0, 0 or 1, 1. So this can be further simplified like this. Q0 having the self loop 0, 1. And after having a self loop of 0, 1, you can reach the next state either 0, 0, either with 0, 0 or with 1, 1. So I can reach the next state. Here the next state is Q1. Don't compare with the above. I am taking states in a sequence. So I can reach the next state either with 0, 0 or with 1, 1. No need to consider this transition, okay? And after that, after reaching the next state with either 0, 0 or 1, 1, I can have again a self loop of 0, 1 and then I can reach the final state. So now I am going to make this Q1 as the final state and here I am considering the self loop of 0, 1 and this can be further expanded like this. So here I am having initial state Q0 and here I am having self loop of 0, 1 and I can reach the final state either with 0, 0 or with 1, 1. So here I can divide this 0, 0 by taking another intermediate state. So here I am taking Q1 and here is my QF. This is the final state. So here I am taking 0, 0. Similarly here I am taking some Q2. So here I am taking instead of 1, 1, I am dividing that 1, 1 into two parts. So here is the first one, here is the second one. And here also I am having self loop of 0, 1. So finally this is the finite automata. This is the required finite automata for the given regular expression. So 0 plus 1 whole star I am having and after that either with 0, 0 or with 1, 1 I can reach the next state and after that I should have 0 plus 1 whole star. 0 plus 1 whole star in the sense I can have closer of either 0 or 1 whatever maybe we can take any of 0 and 1. So in this way we can get the finite automata from the given regular expression and thank you for watching the video.